Criminal syndicates posing as legitimate offshore gaming operators are considered a national security concern. That's according to Philippine Defense Secretary Gilberto Teodoro. He said, the government must put a stop to these syndicates, which weaken the country's financial standing and corrupt the society. This comes after authorities discovered alleged Chinese military uniforms and other illegal items at a Pogo hub in Porac Town in Pampanga. As for the Philippine military, Pogos are not yet considered a threat to national security.
For now, it's an all hands on deck on all the agencies that are involved.
Okay.
So in our case, EUP emphasizes the need for thorough investigation to ensure that Pogo operations comply with national laws and regulations. So it is crucial for all the stakeholders involved to work together to address any criminal activities that are being taken into consideration, and also to mitigate the risks to public safety and national security. For now, that is not considered as a threat to national security. In terms of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, we remain committed to maintaining a balanced approach in safeguarding our economic interests, because it also poses economic interests, while prioritizing the well-being and security of our citizens.
The U.S. government is reportedly planning to announce wider sanctions on the sale of semiconductor chips and other goods to Russia. Reuters says the sanctions will target third-party entities in China that sell to Russia. The move is part of the Biden administration's response to Russia's efforts to circumvent Western sanctions. This comes ahead of a Group of Seven Leaders summit in Italy, where the war in Ukraine is among the top agenda.
Here's something for the armies or fans of the hit K-pop group BTS. One of its members, Jin, now finally has the, well, permission to dance as he concludes his mandatory military service. The eldest BTS member, Kim Seokjin, was discharged from military duty today, becoming the first member of the band to do so. He emerged from the gates of the army base in Yeoncheon, where he was welcomed by his fellow BTS mates, J-Hope, V, as well as RM, Jungkook, and Jimin. The global group went on a hiatus in 2022 as its members began their service required for Korean men under 30. Shares of BTS talent agency HYBE were up nearly 0.5% this Wednesday on news of Jin's military service conclusion.
To China, its consumer inflation held steady in May. Data from Beijing Statistics Bureau show the consumer price index in the world's second largest economy rose 0.3% in May from a year earlier, below the expected 4.4% rise. Month-on-month, CPI edged down 0.1% versus a 0.1% rise in April. Meanwhile, producer prices, which are stuck in deflation since September 2022, fell at a slower 1.4% pace in May after contracting 2.5% in April.
The Labor Department is reminding employers to ensure their workers will get the right pay. According to the Philippine Labor Code, employees out of work on regular holidays, such as today, get double their wage for the first 8 hours. Those who work overtime get an extra 30% of their hourly rate for each additional hour at work. And if, by luck, you're reporting to office today on your rest day, the employer pays an additional 30% of the basic wage at 200%. As for those taking their time off, they remain entitled to getting paid, provided they reported to work on June 11 or the day immediately preceding the holiday.